Okay, we hope you've been enjoying our penultimate night of live action. The last instalment. Don't worry, we're coming back tomorrow for the 4x4s. And now it's the real speed merchants going toe-to-toe. Oh, I like that from the Ghanaians. They look like a boy band. Ha! Ready to go on stage, don't they? Well, it is a stage. It's a stage to the world. One in which the audience is watching from far away. Excellent team from Germany. Their solo gold back in 1960 in Rome. Could they spring a huge surprise? And what about the Canadians? Bronze 5 years ago in Rio, their last gold was 96. Donovan Bailey et al. And they've got the 200-metre Olympic champion, André de Grasse. It's arguably the Canadians' best chance. Johan Blake, the senior man of this team now, wearing the trademark shades, still the third fastest man in history.
Both the Canadians and Jamaicans, a nice respectful bow. I like that. I like that entrance.
The British quartet will be buoyed by what the British women have just achieved. Could they deliver? Watch Xu Bing Chan on the third leg for China. Remember, he didn't get a medal in the 100, but he ran 9.83 in the semis, and his bend in the heats was phenomenal. The Italians, no medal, by the way, since 1948. 70 years of history, and what a chance. Jacobs, the newly crowned 100-metre Olympic champion. Watch for him down the back straight on leg two. And here's another little subplot to this delicious relay. The Japanese, silver in Rio, bronze in the last two editions of the World Championship. They've never won the gold. They are such a well-drilled quartet. This would be the perfect place and the perfect platform for them to take their inaugural 4x1 title. And yes, they haven't got the crowd, but they've got the knowledge that their whole country will be poised and watching. Confirm the lanes for you. Ghana will be in two, Germany three, Canada four. Remember their last title in 96. De Grasse goes anchor. That's Richard Kilty. He'll go round the second bend for Great Britain. Johan Blake, he'll also be on the second bend. Used to call himself the Beast. That's Jacobs, the reigning Olympic champion. He'll go down the back straight. Watch him fly for the Azzurri as he did in the final. Britain in six. China will be in seven. Italy second from the outside, and watch for the Japanese. But on paper, with Aaron Brown, who was in the 200 final, Jerome Blake, Brendan Rodney and André de Grasse, the Canadians could upset everybody, and it would be the perfect finish for de Grasse, as it would be for Lamont Marcell Jacobs. Could Italy produce their first medal since 1948? That's so long ago, that's the year my dad was born. The Jamaicans go in five. And don't rule out Great Britain. World champions 4 years ago, got a silver 2 years ago in Doha. They will be sandwiched between Jamaica and China.
The joy when Nathan Neal Mitchell Brake came across the line in that gold medal is still pretty vivid. Just a primal scream of celebration.
What we've seen in the Olympic Stadium shows that despite the lack of crowd, these men and women are still delivering their very best. And that tells you what becoming an Olympic champion still means. That's what it meant to Jacobs. That's what it meant to André de Grasse, who'll be on the anchor leg. That's their lead-off, Aaron Brown, who was also in that 200 final. Shuhi Tada on lead leg for the Japanese. They've left their two best till last. Kiryu will go round the second bend, and it'll be Koike, the Asian Games champion over 200 metres. He'll go anchor for the Japanese. The tension mounts. There's a smile there for Javon Minzi. but the sweat and the eyes tell you a different story. This isn't just for them, it's for their teammates and their country. The final, the men's 4x100m relay. Canada 4, Jamaica 5, Great Britain 6, watch for Italy in 8, Japan right on the outside in lane 9. Time to deliver. The first strike then. It's an excellent run by the Japanese on the outside. Watch for a clean set of changeovers. And the Japanese have dropped it. They're absolutely heartbroken. Lamont Marcell Jacobs round that top bend, but Britain going really well here. Richard Kielty, watch for Siu Bing Tan closing the gap, and the Italians aren't out of this. The Jamaicans have got a lot to do here, so too the Canadians. And look at this. Nathaniel Mitchell-Blake, Great Britain, Italy. And it's the Italians, I think, on the line. It's so, so close. Neither of them are certain. But I think the Italians have just done it. If they have, it's the dip on the line to deny Great Britain. For a moment, it looked as though Nathaniel Mitchell-Blake had repeated Britain's win in 2004. But how about that from the Italians? I thought they had a chance. Jacobs was brilliant down the back straight. Three golds in the athletics becomes four. The Azzurri move into uncharted territory. They have not won a medal in the men's 4x1 for over 70 years. And they've never taken gold. They have now. They have now. That was the finish of a lifetime from Tortu. Nathaniel Mitchell-Blake thought he had done it, but by 1/100th of a second, with a national record, the Italians create history for a European nation who are delivering on the highest level. Richard Kielty is having to console his teammates. Reactions of contrasting emotion here. All the glory, all the glitz, and the gold belongs to the Italians. Tortu can hardly believe what he has just achieved for his country. I tell you what, he will be a household name from this night onwards. How on earth did he close down that gap? And by the way, the Canadians came through for bronze. Yes.
Well, as handoff goes, if you see it again, that first handoff to Jacobs was magnificent. Hand low, he's got it, and the ground he made up and that he put out there for the rest of the Italian team was amazing. Another good handoff, both sides.
And look how far behind the Jamaicans and the Canadians were at this stage. Richard Kielty ran an excellent bend. He's the world indoor champion, former world indoor champion over 60. I think the reason Nathaniel Mitchell-Blake is so inconsolable because in this moment he thought he'd secured the gold. And everybody talks about Lamont Marcell Jacobs, of course, having a fantastic dip by Tortu. But Tortu is the first Italian male to break 10 seconds. He had the national record before Lamont Marcell Jacobs broke it and became the Olympic champion. It was a fantastic all-round team effort. And what a story for the Italians. By a hundredth of a second, that was phenomenal. They have been one of the most successful nations here in the Athletic Stadium, and never before have they secured four goals. That is an outstanding achievement. De Grasse gets another medal, it's a bronze, and he's over the moon because he came from nowhere to secure that and deny the Chinese quartet, who tied their national record. The Jamaicans were fifth. It wasn't to be glorious for them. The Italians have been one of the stories of the Athletic Stadium, and they richly, richly deserve to bask in the glory by the narrowest of margins. But you know what made the difference? It's almost always the athlete with the faster momentum coming to the finish line who wins those dips. Nathaniel Mitchell-Blake was tying up. Tortu's momentum was carrying him towards the line, and he's done it.
And he's still trying to get over it. Despite his teammates smiling, get him, but he had it there again, right? You have it in your hands. And he just is... Might be the saddest guy here in the stadium right now when he comes through.
I don't think he lost
that
leg. Tortu won it.
Guy got him, right.
He was beaten by a guy who was in inspired form, riding high on the back of unprecedented Italian momentum.
A lot of Union Jacks right there.
Two 4x1s, two medals. An air of relief, I'm sure, in the British camp. And there's Laura Muir in the centre of them. So,
been a good hour.
Three sets of medals. A turn of fortune after Dina Asher-Smith failing to make the final and Katarina Johnson-Thompson crashing out in the heptathlon. But what about the Azzurri? We thought that moment between Tamberi and Lamont Marcell Jacobs was good. Mm-hmm. This was even better. And it was the quintessential definition of an all-round team effort.
Yeah. Well, that first leg was pretty even with everybody. And then the Jamaicans, a couple of three clutches to get the stick there. I mean, that is all kinds of ugly right there. And by that time, in this group, everybody's gone.
Watch the quality of the bend here from Richard Kilty. Absolutely superb. And the Italian, Desalu, handing on to Filippo Tortu.
Really, as passes goes, the teams that were there at the top of the board handed it off terrifically. And this, how many times will that be replayed again and again on Italian television?
You could tell by the way he dipped that he had just done it. And you could also tell by Nathaniel Mitchell-Blake's reaction that he knew it was silver and not gold.
Yeah, they didn't have to go to the photo. They knew. Right in that moment, both of them absolutely knew. And really, it speaks a bit to the American fortunes on the men's side. Listen, they've got a ton of medals, but they weren't in this because they dropped it. And here are the Italians who have more gold medals than the U.S. men's team in this meet. Not more overall, but they have more trips to the top of the podium.
And it's only just occurred to me, Lamont Marcell Jacobs is a double Olympic champion.
Yes.
As unbelievable. If someone had said to him before he arrived here, by the way, in your hand luggage, you'll have two Olympic golds, he probably would not have dared to believe them. Mm. Oh, and by the way, it was a national record for the Italians as well, 37.50.
Look at it. It was by nearly half a second. Like, usually you shave a tenth. If you're lucky, that's a big thing, or a hundredth. But they went from 37.95 to 37.50.
It was a great, great race and a brilliant finish. I mentioned that Joshua Cheptegei will never have to buy a beer again in Uganda. I'm not sure Filippo Tortu...
Somewhere on the D, somewhere for these high jumpers, but it's pretty still inside the stadium. And I can say that with a surety because I'm looking up at higher and the flags that circle the arena at the top level are hardly moving. So much for that cyclone that they threatened us with. earlier today. And actually, there was potential rain in Guy, but that isn't with us, fingers crossed, either.
Don't start talking about cyclones when we've all got to fly home in 2 days' time. Anyway, on to the medal presentation. Mrs. Danka Martakova from Slovakia, IOC member.
IOC member, Slovakia, Olympian, one bronze medal.
Great country, Slovakia. I've had a good time in Bratislava. Very hospitable, convivial people. Fantastic architecture in the capital. And she will be accompanied by Mrs. Anna Riccardi. No wonder she's smiling. She might as well retire. If she's going to make a medal presentation as an Italian, this is about as good as it's going to get. Even her mask's slipping off. Yet another bronze for André de Grasse on the right of picture. And how he came through in flying colours. They had a little bit of work to do. RN Brown, Jerome Blake, Brendan Rodney and de Grasse came through to deny the Chinese by 9/100ths. And the Chinese ran 37.79.
He'll only be 29 when they go to Paris 3 years from now, DeGrasse. So I think he's got some good heats and championships still in him by a lot.
I agree. Injuries notwithstanding, touchwood. And how well did he bounce back from those between Rio and Tokyo? Absolutely incredible major championship performer. So pleased for him and his three teammates. So we've seen two bronze medals for the Canadians, 4x1 in the men's 50K race walk. They were so, so close to gold. To be accurate, a single hundredth of a second. CJ Uja, Zarnell Hughes, Richard Kilty, third from the right, who ran a brilliant second bend. And then Nathaniel Mitchell-Blake, who arguably felt the tension, felt the tightness, felt the Italian closing, and just failed to outdip him on the line. A magnificent team effort for the silver. But at the end, he was inconsolable. Hopefully, he's had a chance to reflect, and he's standing on the Olympic podium as a silver medalist, and those moments are absolutely priceless. It's a team effort. It doesn't come down to him. He was blaming himself, though, at the end of the race.
Listen, I can understand being that despondent. It's the old, if you lose by one or you lose by 1 second, which one would be easier to take? And to have it there and to lead for what was essentially 399 meters and a little bit and get dipped. I don't know that you are over it just quite yet.
The Italian delegation over by the high jump are preparing to go wild for the Azzurri once more. Absolutely incredible from the Italians. Lorenzo Patta, Lamont Marcell Jacobs, the Olympic champion. What a games he's had. Stormed down the back straight to Eseosa, Desalu, the 27-year-old, and Filippo Tortu, almost the forgotten man of Italian sprinting, by the way, because he was the first Italian to break 10 seconds. And then came Lamont Jacobs, the transferee, very proud of his Italian heritage. And he was the one who lowered the Italian record further. But people were very quick to forget Tortu broke the major barrier there for Italy, and he ran the leg of his life down the home straight. He'll never pay for a meal back home in Italy ever again. I don't think any of his team will. And once again, we hear one of the best anthems in the world. The Italians are on fire.
Thank you.
is brilliant. This is absolutely brilliant. We all just took our headsets off so that we could hear the four men's teammates over on the far side, a little bank of teammates of all different nations ready to watch the high jump final. And you could hear them all singing. It was absolutely brilliant. And Jacobs just wiped tears away from his eyes there. Jacobs is second from the left.
I'm getting to the point where I think I might know the words, actually.
I was just going to say, I think I can hum the whole thing now.
Well, hum it, I can sing it, I think.
And listen, it was a small crowd, but they were full throat, were they not?